Gang, today we go over the Season 3 roadmap for Warzone 2.0. There's a bunch of really cool features coming out. I am excited for this season, I will say, but with the past couple seasons I've been excited, I feel like I've been let down. Maybe this will be the new season that will turn the tables, but only time will tell. Let's go over this roadmap together. If you're new to the channel, hit that sub button, man. Crush that like button. Let's get right into it. All right, gang, so the roadmap for Season 3. So right here off the bat, we can see that for Warzone 2.0, we have Plunder coming back, which I always like Plunder for rank camp weapons. It's definitely the fastest way to level up guns because you're getting Warzone XP. There's not really that big of a death penalty. Easy way to rack up kills and level up guns. Warzone ranked, I'm super excited to get into that conversation. Massive Resurgence, again, I'm excited for that. And then we have this bottom row, these new BR gameplay features, the new features. They're all from Warzone 1. Every one of these features are absolutely from Warzone 1, but that's fine if they want to. It's like we talked about in the last one of these roadmap videos. They make them oopsie, and then they promote something that like should have been there in the first place as this new, brand new, innovative thing. It's kind of frustrating, but let's get on with the roadmap. Look, so Gunfight is returning. This is for multiplayer. Gunfight is 2v2. Almost like team deathmatch mixed with search and destroy. If you've never played it, it is a ton of fun. I actually really, really enjoy Gunfight. So I'm excited to see that come back. Maybe I'll do a Gunfight series on the channel. They used to do little Gunfight tournaments and Grizz and I had a blast on those. Here are some new maps they're gonna have for the Gunfights. They look pretty cool. We got Alley, Black Site, Shipment, Exhibit. Pretty cool. Okay, let's see. I don't know what this is right here. This is going to be a core map at launch. Paleo's Lighthouse. That actually looks sick. At first in the trailer, I thought this was Rebirth Island. I'm going to keep it a buck. This is from the campaign, 100%. One of the first campaign missions, you actually go in here and get like missiles out. I definitely recognize that building. Super cool. And then this is from Almazar as well. Afghan's coming back. I think they actually changed the name of it. Satik Cave Complex. We all know what it is. But cool. I'm glad they added some new battle maps. That's not what we're here for today. We are here for the juice right here. We got new rank play rewards. If you are into rank play is a lot of fun. Good way to grind out camos and skins, get them high ranks. This is the beauty right here. Warzone 2.0 overview. All right, look, we play Warzone on this channel. So what we really want to cover right here. So we got Massive Resurgence imminent. At launch, up to 150 players can drop in for Resurgence across Almazar. Expect chaos and plenty of XP. There's going to be somebody who drops 100 kills in this game mode. Absolutely unreal. 150 player Resurgence. I mean, this makes me think a lot about buyback quads that they did in Warzone 1. I mean, the kills in that were outrageous. I mean, you'd have 28, 27 kills, you know, with like 100 people still up. I mean, this is outrageous. So I'm super excited for that. We're gonna have to set some really big goals for that and make sure we drop some super bombs. Prepare for plunder again. Team-based respawn enabled, mad dash for cash.
Excuse me.
Ooh. Here, right here, this is mimicking. I had to yawn for that. That's literally it puts me to sleep every time that they talk about old features that should be here that they're promoting. So right here, redeploy drones are coming back in Almazra. Should have been there in the first place. Protect yourself with a tempered plate carrier. We've had that. Oh, perk packages. You can loot them off the ground. Had that. UAV towers. Had that. And more. I'm excited that they're bringing them back, but it's frustrating that it's once again just announced as something like new and exciting when should have been there in the first place.
Oh my goodness.
I'm tired, gang. I'm sorry. I'm going to yawn a few times in the video. I'm just, the boy's tired. All right, fans of fast-paced Resurgence mode, it's me, will have a new version of Resurgence to look forward to in addition to Ashika Island and remaining as a game mode option. Look, Resurgence is already a blast with like 45 people, I think, is in a match, 40 people. I can't imagine it with 150. I am absolutely stoked for that. Plunder again, super fast way to level up guns. I'm excited for plunder. New gulag in Almazra. This is, you know, should have happened already with Season 2. They rotating gulags is a good thing. They need to keep that fresh. So we got a new gouge coming. looks pretty cool. I'm excited for that. New and returning features to Battle Royale. Thank God they said returning features. There we go. Returning. That's huge that they're actually saying that. Redeploy is coming out, which if you play Sheik Island, you know what these are. Tempered plate carriers at launch. I want to see what they say. Ooh. Another Caldera first feature. Tempered plate carriers change how your operator handles armor plates. I don't know why they say Caldera first. And we had tempered plates before Caldera. Anyways, your armor will be now two half bars instead of 3/3, making it easier. So essentially two plates instead of three will be tempered. You'll be full. DMZ UAV towers are vital fixed sources that can be activated during a match. Those are just coming to Warzone 2 now. Pretty neat. More to come at mid-season. Let's see. In addition to the above, expect even more new changes in returning features. Perk packages. Here we go. Another item to the loot pool with Warzone Season 3 is the present perk package, which can be found in supply boxes. Specific lower rarity perk packages are available at buy stations. So I guess you can buy perks now. It's kind of cool, but I mean, in the same sense, what are we doing here? Like, let's just make the buy stations simple, easy, one list, not too much. You get a loadout. I mean, the blueprint's there, boys. Deployable buy stations coming back. Pretty neat. I enjoyed those. I always thought that was kind of fun. Gulag entry kit. I have no idea what that is. One last literal small item with a massive potential impact is the Gulag entry kit. Those who find one in Battle Royale match and perish beyond their initial Gulag can re-enter the fight via the Gulag, which means those who know they can clutch up that 1v1 and have another chance to get a redeployment without needing to request one from your squad mate. So I guess like if you've already like died, you've gone to Guj and you want to go to Guj again, you can get an entry kit. It's like a second chance then, I guess. I'm not too sure. We'll have to see on that. There's a barter system coming to DMZ. One of the biggest additions to DMZ is a barter system, a way to award operators who stock up on items and can reach a buy station to swap them for other valuables. In general, the trader may not have what you want, but they will always have what you need. Kind of cool. I like that. They're also going to add a workbench. You can start to craft stuff. It says right here. You can modify contraband weapons with these workbenches. So that's pretty neat. In Season 3, you won't just have one operator infiltrate the denied areas. Every player will start with three active duty operator slots, which equates to having three separate operators who have their own on-soldier items. These items include your backpack, plate carrier, kill streak, self-revive, and gas mask. For every infiltration you choose, you can choose which active duty operator you bring in, meaning that you can calculate risk to whatever missions you want to tackle or the type of experience you want to have for that match. That's pretty cool. So they all have different features, different things you can do with them. I think that's kind of neat. Got a new faction coming, Redacted. It's coming to Season 3. We'll have three of its missions tiers at launch, plus two more in season. So they're going to remix some missions and contracts. That's fun. Change things up. We got the World Series of Warzone coming back actually this month. So we should have qualifiers. Let's see. Official this year's series on the 6th. So we should have World Series of Warzone qualifiers soon. I'm sure we'll go for that, see what we can do. Warzone rank play is almost here. I think this comes out mid-season. Let's see. It says it's going to be a trio that everyone's been wondering. So assemble the trio and prepare for the road to the top 250. Developed by Treyarch and Raven Software, Call of Duty rank play will act as the proving ground and true test for trios wanting to become the best in the world. Super duper sick. We are 100% grinding that. Like, I'm telling the gang right now, we are grinding Warzone rank. We'll be top 50. You already know this. It's not even a question. That's light. General overview. So we got some new operators, new characters coming, stuff. You know how they do every season. You know, they got some people mostly from campaigns. We got Alejandro and Valeria. I hope I said that right. Valeria. I'm not even gonna butcher that. I sound like a video right now. These bitter rivals, blah, 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 they're going to be duking out. Intervention's coming back. I mean, it's cool. There's not too much they could do with this game that would just make me fall in love with it again, other than being like, hey, we fixed how clunky our engine is. That'd be super sick. I would be excited about that. Cronin Squall Battle Rifle. Cool. I think that's dope. Hopefully it rips, you know, that'd be super fun. I like when they add new guns, absolutely rip. And then new battle pass offering, the Black Cell. Super dope. Gang, look, I think we're gonna wrap up here. Recruit a friend. This right here, I saw so many responses on Twitter about this today, it cracked me up. They have this new thing called Recruit a Friend, and essentially you can invite your friends and get rewarded for them recruiting to start playing the game. Let's just rename this to, instead of introducing Recruit a Friend, introducing Please Save Us, Our Game is Dying, We Need People to Play This Game. That's what it should be called. Absolutely silly that they made that a thing, but whatever. That's what happens when your game's dying. Hopefully they can fix it though. I think they're on the, like, they're on a teeter-totter right now of like, this is too, like, too late, not too late, and they're like, they're kind of like right here. You know, they're wobbling, but they're more or less, might be too late for this title, but we're gonna embrace it. We love Call of Duty, so we're gonna see what we can do with it. Look, gang, if you're new to the channel, enjoy the content, man. Hit that sub button, press that like button. Catch y'all tomorrow for another banger. Let's get it.